What's going on Blessed Gamers? Melfice X here. And we are back with some Diablo 3. Continuing our playthrough with the Necromancer. I believe we're level 43? Let me just confirm. No, level 44. We're still battling our way through Act 3. And we are playing on hard. Let's continue this. We're currently playing the Machines of War. So, yeah, really liking our build right now. Very cool build. Got the Ice Command Skeletons. Let me just run through my skills, just in case you guys don't know what build we're running. We got the Siphon Blood with that increases the damage the longer that I siphon the target. We got the Bone Spear with the crystallization that reduces the enemy attack speed and increases our attack speed for each enemy hit. We got the Corpse Lance, Brittle Touch, which increases the chance to crit the enemies. We got the Ice Command, the Freezing Command Skeletons. We got the cool Leech. We got Sanguine End on it, which is whenever a cursed enemy dies, you are healed based on the life per kill. And for our final skill, we're running with the Bone Armor, which increases the damage dealt to the enemies for each person that I absorb. And for the passives, we got Swift Harvesting, increasing the attack of Bone Spike, Siphon Blood, and Grim Scythe. Bone Prison, which is really cool. It kind of like jails the enemy. It has a 30% chance to basically jail the enemy that I'm attacking with either Bone Spear, Bone Spikes, or Bone Spirit. And Fueled by Death, which by consuming a corpse, it increases our movement by 3% for 5 seconds. And we could actually stack that up to 10 times. So that's what we're running for the build. Pretty cool. Great to control large crowds. So, we sold everything. I believe we sold everything. Before we quit, before we end the stream, so yesterday, so let's get back into that portal and
took down Belial and Count Diem.
So I think we went this way. Well, I think we were going this way.
Sin.
How are we doing with gold right now? Got 708. I want to hit a million. I really do want to hit a million. How was that? I thought those were goblins or something. Freeze him a little bit. I don't know what the hell is that thing that keeps on, Oh shit, they are goblins. No wonder, I was like, it sounds like goblins, but I can't see them.
I require a corpse for that.
Let's find the other one.
I require a corpse for that.
We couldn't hold on. There were just too many of them.
Men are losing hope.
Alright, level 45.
Endless. They come at all times, day or night. And no amount of casualties we inflict slows their advance. We need reinforcements. We need help.
Alright, so one thing I forgot to do was socket my items with some gems. Was supposed to do that, but completely forgot.
My essence is too low.
I have no use for it anymore.
Can't go there yet.
There is nothing I loathe more than failure. You know this well. But if any of you need a further lesson, I will have
that
you
needs
delivered
to
into the Circle of Wrath with great haste. The enemy is strong, but he cannot pass the demon gates. Secure it. Your lives will be forfeit.
Thank you. An interesting opponent. I must have a corpse.
Actually really nice. A huge crowd. Can't get any better than that.
Alright, so we're going through quite a few crowds here. Not that many elites, but
we are leveling, we are killing a lot of experience to level up, so.
You know what, we never went down and explored further down by the southwest corner.
Freeze him up a little bit.
I'm afraid not.
Hopefully I don't get overburdened on the next pickups.
Look out! They've been circling for hours.
I should probably, give me a second, I think I should probably go to town and unburden all this load. Alright guys, we're back. Alright, so I'm thinking about going to town. And, first let's go through the stuff that we got. So, we know if it's good or not. Do we got anything useful that are... power up our build? One thing about me is I'll never replace a legendary with a magic, even if it's higher in stats. I just love those legendary properties, so we'll not do it. I will change it for the rare though, because the rare has good properties. Better properties than the magic items. This is a two-socketed item. That could give us a potential of a lot of stuff. Nothing with the boots. Got my two-handed scythe, so that's taken up pretty much all that. This is a tough one, just because obviously it gives me a little upgrade on attack, a nice upgrade on defense and vitality. Now the legendary properties that I have on this current Death Watch mantle shoulders, it's pretty much favoring a lot of the stuff that I don't use. I don't use Bone Spirit and I don't use Fan of Knives. I like the reduces cooldown of all skills by 5%, but this Blazon Mutiny rare shoulders does give me 11% plus on the bone armor damage, so guess I'm gonna have to make that switch. Alright, so let's go to town.
I'm returning to town.
Let's go see the merchant. Let's go salvage some items. And then we'll keep it moving. Oh, and we have to socket items. Cannot forget that we do have to socket items. Yeah, got quite a few things to socket, so.
A caravan made it through. My people have been lost, scattered with winds, but I will survive as long as you, my son.
Alright, so we sold everything we had to sell. Now let's salvage the rest for material.
Things are looking up, Martyr.
You know what? Let's combine first. Let's combine gems to make stronger gems. I haven't really done that, so we could actually. And we got enough money and currency to do it, so. Why not? Well, this is definitely taking up a bite of our currency, but it's for the better. This is how you raise attack and items and stuff like that. So we just used an easy 200,000, but gems hold, you know, gems hold value, man. Custom fit. Craft 100 items. Okie dokes. Go. Alright, so we pretty much. Pretty much combine everything that we could combine. So now let's sock it, right? Alright, so diamonds. It gives us 12% damage to elite enemies, reduces cooldown of all skills by 8%. So if we put on a helm, it actually gives us, it helps our cooldowns. So that's legit. And if we put on the weapon, it gives us plus damage against elites. So let's definitely reduce cooldown of all skills by 8%. That's like a plus. Now, what gives us intelligence? Because that's what we need, intelligence, right? That's our main. Okay, so topaz and emeralds give us 100% critical damage if we put on the weapon. And amethyst deals with primarily vitality and life. So topaz is what we really want, and we could actually put this on anything, on any other equipment. So like the necklace, bam. Armor, even better. Critical hits, put that on the weapon, right? And if we put this, all right, so I think we gotta just go topaz. Alright, so we're socking it up. I think we're running a nice build. Alright, let's go make some of that money back, because we definitely spent some money. But I think we did it. I think we did it the right way. I think we made a hell of a investment, and let's see if it pays off. Not. That was a little tough right there. That elite was taking some hits. So one thing I do notice is that the cooldown is much more definitely reduced. So it's a nice pace on it. Seem like I'm getting the critical. I think the critical is supposed to show up in orange. If I remember. I think it's orange. So that was cool because it jailed them. It actually jailed the
A
an interesting opponent. I require a corpse for that.
Oh, that was a critical. So one thing I'm noticing is that I'm getting quite a few more jailed attacks. I don't know if it's something I did with the gems, but
that is not possible.
I think we might even be able to bump it up to expert on the next like playthrough. All right, so that's it for this dungeon.
So I think we're good to go up north. I think that barricade that they were trying to break down, I think, might be open.
I could no longer sit idly by while you brought the fight to Asmodan. It has been too long since I felt the thrill of battle myself.
Siege weapons makes little difference. Every hour, more of my forces pour. pour forth from the mouth of hell. Soon, they will wipe your pathetic keep from existence.
Brave words, Asmodan. But words are all you have left to hurl at us. Forward, friend. Now we shall drive Asmodan's army back into the accursed crater.
Together, we can defeat them.
Alright, Tyrael with that good shit talking. Talking that good shit.
This creature will die. My essence is too low. Give it more time. Is not possible.
Thanks to you. Let's go!
That's just a massacre right there.
That needs to recharge.
You defy the corpse.
The battle is up. Damn, 85 killed.
I'm just a scout. I was supposed to survey the
battle. I think that's the most I've gotten.
Along with my lieutenant. But we were attacked. I still have a spyglass here. Please, take it to my lieutenant. I don't know how long he'll be able to hold out up there.
Alright, so am I missing any locations? There's that little area where I should have gone, like, up the staircase. Like, to the left, like, swing around. I could go back and check it out. Alright, so that was actually good that we actually went there to complete the quest.
Thank you.
Alright, so far we're back up to 411,000. So we're making our money back.
Eldruin will destroy the demonic seal protecting this gate.
Oh wow, we're actually fighting that right now. Thought I dodge roll. I didn't leave anything behind, right? Oh, shh. Wait a minute. I did leave that square diamond.
Come with urgent news. Leah has had another vision. A vision of twisted demonic towers and enormous hearts beating within them.
I know of them. They are the Sin Hearts. Asmodan must have dredged them up from the depths of his realm to empower his legions.
Not for long.
Thank you.
Alright, so go through the Ariat Crater and find the Tower of the Damned.
I am close to Asmodan, and his desperation is clear. Whatever vile contraptions he uses to aid his army will not be enough to protect him from me.
You've killed one of my playthings. Now, you have my undivided attention.
Give me 1 second, guys. I'll be right back.
Corner of the burning hells you lounge in, and bring your daughters with you.